Lino, question about your background.
Yeah.
What have you done before? I mean, what led it to Frozen for you?
Well, I've been at Disney for 15 years, and I started off in school doing hand-drawn, and then I took a computer animated class, and drawing for me was very difficult. But then I was able, because I love acting, but I hate being in front of the camera. So CG comes around, and I could very much focus on the acting. And that got me incredibly excited, and I started at Disney as an animator. Then I became a supervising animator on Bolt, a supervising animator on Tangled, and now I'm head of animation on Frozen.
What have you learned from the successes or failure or accidents that you've had in your career that you could apply to Frozen?
Yeah, what we learned on Tangled, I made that the starting point for Frozen.
Okay.
So bringing the characters to life, we call it emotion in detail, truth in acting, and having the animators very much explore, is what we're doing, is it the right choice? Because in animation, it's very easy to get caught up in the art of making the art look really appealing, instead of, is it the right thing to do for that very particular shot? And just making sure we're crescendoing in the right place and holding some animators back, then going for it. So you're not listening to a performance that's always on 12. Because sometimes every animator, we get a shot, and it feels like they're separate. So every animator,
that's interesting.
And every animator wants to make it like, I'm going to show you how great of an artist I am. But sometimes it's not right for the shot. So on this film, everything that we learned on Tangled and Wreck-It Ralph, and then here we are today, working with talented directors and John Lasseter, who can. It's interesting how we've had so many great sessions collaborating. About just the right performance.
Because I'm looking at the hair of the picture behind you.
Yeah.
I guess with Tangles now it's easy for you to control hairs, right?
Oh, God. You'd think that, right? That once you, like on Rapunzel, once we did that, you'd think we could, all right, we could do any type of hair, but it's not the case.
Oh, it's never easy then.
No, every film has their unique challenges. I think with Elsa, the style of the hair, and in CG, if you have something that's asymmetrical, like Elsa's hairstyle that went over her shoulder. Now, all of a sudden, depending on the camera angle, that hairstyle becomes very challenging. Silhouette-wise, it may not look as appealing as you thought about it being profile. Yeah.
It looks like it's a golden age for animation again. All the studios are competing with that. How does Disney get ahead of the game all the time? Is it the team? I mean, is there something special about Disney Pixar that makes it so special?
I do. You know what? I feel like as long as we approach the characters truthfully, and it's all about the performance, basically that feeling of you want to create characters that you're rooting for. And I feel like that keeps us very honest, and it keeps our films special so that, again, it's very easy to get caught up in animation and do things very broad and big, and but I think when you pull back and you make the honesty of the characters come through, I feel like that you end up with what Disney is known for, and I feel like Frozen's is the perfect example of that.
What do you think the viewers will enjoy about Frozen?
The thing is this is one of the few films that will be in a review session. And we'll be looking to critique shots, and you're in the room, and you watch the movie, and I think it's a testament to how well written the characters are. So again, I think rooting for the characters, as soon as the film starts and you go on the journey, you forget the medium, you forget that it's animated, and you're rooting for the characters. I really believe it that the audiences are just going to be cheering on the characters.
La Reine des Neiges, le nouveau dessin animé des studios Disney, Frozen, à voir sur nos écrans. Lino, merci beaucoup. Thank you very much.
Thank you.